Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of .NET, that is .NET version 9 on Windows operating system. And after that I will show you how you can easily create a .NET project and how to run that on our console. So I recommend you to watch the video till the end, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel. That going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. And also please do follow us on Instagram. And now to install .NET, it first simply go to favorite browser and then to search over here .NET SDK download and hit enter. So that going to show you this .NET.microsoft.com. So you need to click on the first link, that is download.NET. So when you click on that, it's going to redirect to official site of Microsoft. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. Once when you are here, you will see that our latest version of .NET, that is version 9, is available to download. You can also see the previous version, that is version 8 as well. So I have already made a detailed video about that, so you can follow that video as well. So this .NET version 8 you can also download. So latest version on .NET 8 is version 8.0.11 and it released on November 12th. But the latest one, the latest .NET version 9 standard term support version is also released on November 12th. So version 9. So you need to click on this download button and it's going to immediately start downloading our latest version of .NET version 9. So thanks for your download. And you can see that our file is rightly started downloading. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finished downloading. And you can see that our file is rightly downloaded. Let's go to our download directory and you can see that our .NET is already been downloaded over here. And the file size is 212 MB. So to install, just simply double click on the installer. And that's going to open this Microsoft .NET SDK version 9 installation wizard. So here you need to read all this information and then you need to click on install. Immediately it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes and there you go. You can see that our setup is in progress. So our .NET version is rightly started installing. By the time it gets installed, I'll request you please to consider subscribing our channel Geeky Syntax. So here I am posting lot of coding related videos. I am also posting a complete detailed tutorial on WordPress. So I highly recommend you to subscribe this channel and also watch my other videos. That going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Escape blogging channel. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our .NET version 9 is successfully installed. So you can see this message also, the installation is successful. Just simply click on close and let's go to search and this time type cmd over here. So let's click on the command prompt to open our command prompt, and within our command prompt, if you write some command like .NET space dash dash info, you'll see this type of prompt. If you get this type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your .NET is rightly installed on your system, and you can also see the latest version of .NET, which is version 9. So that version is also showing. So you need to basically type this .NET space dash dash info on cmd, and if you get this type of prompt, then you just know that .NET is rightly installed. But if you see some different type of message, then all that basically mean is the .NET is not installed. So you need to follow this video all over again and install .NET properly as I am showing on this video. And also if you want, you can also ask all of your doubts on comment sections and on our Instagram as well. Now let's close this and let's do some coding. So let's start with creating a .NET project. So I'll just simply create a folder on our desktop. So just give that folder name as .NET project and let's go inside that folder. So here in our address bar, just simply type cmd to open our command prompt right at this location of .NET project, and within this project within this command prompt, if you just simply write a simple command like .NET space new list, so that's going to show you list of all the projects that are available on .NET. So you can see that our API controller, ASP.NET code, empty project, and all these different projects are rightly showing over here, right, with corresponding short name as well. So you can see this is a console app, then corresponding short name is also there, right? So you can also create MVC controller or MVC view imports projects, all that. So only thing that you need to remember is to create such projects, you need to use this short name. So I'm going to show you where to use the short name. Just keep watching this video. So you can see, to create a web config project, you need to use this command called web config, right? So let's see how we can create a project. Just type .NET new, and then it provide your short name. So let's say I am to create a class library project. So I need to use this command called class lib. So after .NET new, you need to write that in a command called class lib. For console app, you need to write console and all that. So you basically understood the point, right? So first you need to give .NET new, and then you need to provide that short name. For console application, we'll just simply type console, and then you need to use this flag called dash dash name, and then you need to provide your project name. So I'm going to give my project name as hello world, so I'll just simply type that, and immediately you can see that it is processing and it is rightly done. So our project is rightly created on this project location, that is .NET project, right? And it also has this hello world.cs proj file, so it is restored succeeded. So you can see this project is also created, right? So we have this obj folder, then this chproj file, and along with program.cs file as well. So everything is rightly there. If you open this program.cs file on your command prompt, you can already see in a sample demo code already written over here. So here we are just simply printing this console dot write line on our console. So if you go back to your command prompt, and if you just simply type .NET build, the name of our chproj file, which is chproj, which is hello world.chproj, you can see that immediately shows some error. So that error mainly because we are not in right directory. We need to go inside that directory, that is hello world project. So currently we are in .NET project directory, we are not inside hello world, so you need to go inside that folder. So type cd hello world and hit enter. So now we are inside our project called hello world, and now if you again rerun that same command, that is .NET build hello world.chproj, immediately will see that our project is rightly started building. And when it get rightly started building, you will see a bin folder getting generated. So that folder is also generated, along with you can see the message called build is succeeded. So if you go inside inside that bin folder, and then you enter into the debug folder, then .NET 9.0 folder, you will see all these different files getting generated over here. So here we have our main file, which is hello world.exe. So now in order to run this hello world.exe, you need to go inside this folder location. So that is basically this bin/debug/net 9.0 folder location. Just type that cd /debug/net 9.0, and you can see that we are now inside that project folder location. And now to run that exe, just simply type hello world.exe, that is basically name of our output file, and immediately we'll get that output on our console, that is hello world. So whatever you have written on your code, that output should be coming right on your console. So you can see clearly that is coming, right? Install latest version of .NET, that is .NET version 9, on a Windows operating system.